So if you watched my previous video on the passing system, you probably, and you followed along, you probably noticed that whenever we passed directly behind us, it was just pushing our player back because the ball was trying to go through the current player passing, and it was just pushing them back to wherever the direction of the ball was going. So this video, I'm going to show you how to fix that. And see, now if we try to pass it directly behind us, it's going to go through us and it's not going to get caught up on anything. And it's a pretty simple trick that I use for stuff like this. Basically, all we're doing is we are changing the layer of the game object very temporarily to where it just ignores the collision of the ball. So let me show you how it works. So first of all, we created some layers over here. Created a player layer, a ground layer, a ball layer, and one called ignore collisions. After we create those layers and assign them to the correct components, we need to go into the project settings under the physics tab and scroll down to the layer collision matrix. And specifically, we want to go to the ignore collisions, and we want to ignore default. We can also ignore itself, and we want to ignore the ball. That's the important one. We ignore collisions with the ball. So then we go over to our passing script, and we just add a method right here. It's actually an IEnumerator. It's a coroutine. And so what it does, all it does is it just takes the player that we pass into it, which we really didn't even have to pass it into it. We could have just put this right here, but dependency injection is never really a bad thing. So we got our player layer, game object dot layer, and then we set it to ignore collisions. We wait 0.2 seconds, and then we set it back to the player layer. And so while it ignores collisions for these 0.2 seconds, that's when the ball passes through it. And we just call this coroutine right here in two spots, there and there, just every time we pass the ball. Right before we add the force, we change the layer to where we ignore collisions with the ball. And it really is that simple. Thank you so much for watching. If you wouldn't mind, just please give me a like and a follow, as that really helps me out with YouTube's algorithm.